I don't know, as a kid, it doesn't really click in that, like, you're not allowed to be in a country where you've lived all your life. I was born in Cuautla, Morelos, but I came to the USA when I was like probably like 4 years old. So I don't really remember a lot about living over there. One of the things that my parents always talked about was that I should try to go to college. And I've always liked school, so I've always wanted to go to college. And I guess when I got older and realized that that it might play an influence if I'm undocumented. I don't know. I didn't really want it to stop me. Before I had my DACA, I had a job, and it was a factory job. It was like $8 an hour. I wasn't really making that much, and I was trying to save up for school, to help myself out as much as I could. And then once I got my DACA, I changed jobs, and it was a big change because I went from $8 to $12 an hour, and it was a big help. Just for my schooling, just my tuitions, book, it was a big help. I'm able to have my driver's license, so I'm able to drive without any worries, drive legally. Because it's very common for undocumented people to have to like drive for needs, like either school, work, or just transportation in general here in Minnesota. So being able to drive legally is a big advantage. And then another one is being able to work legally, which opens the doors to a lot of different jobs that you wouldn't be able to do if you weren't undocumented. Which in my case, it helps me a lot because I'm able to find a better job and be able to help myself pay for school. Before, I would think about going to college and like graduating college and like getting a career as a dream. And now I actually like going to college and like being like I feel like I see myself accomplishing that dream. And it's more like a vocal goal now that like I know I can do it.